In the last session, we discussed about no load test and a block rotor test of a three-phase induction motor. These experiments are performed to draw the circle diagram of a three-phase induction motor. The circle diagram is a graphical representation of an equivalent circuit of three-phase induction motor. With the help of circle diagram, we can determine the characteristics of a three-phase induction motor. Yes, sir. Before drawing the circle diagram, let us see what are the parameters that we need to extract from the no-load test and the block rotor test. Yes, from the no-load test, we should get the value of open circuit voltage. We should know the value of short circuit open circuit current. But placing the watt meter, we determine the open circuit power. We can write as POC is equal to root 3 into VOC, IOC into cos 5OC. OC represents the open circuit. Open circuit is nothing but the no load test. Hence, from that, I want 5OC. 5OC is equal to cos inverse of POC divided by root 3 into VOC into IOC. Yes, these values are very required to draw the circle diagram. This is completely from the OC test. Similarly, we should conduct an SC test, that is a block rotor test. From the block rotor test, we need to get the value of VSC. We should know the value of ISC. By placing the watt meter, I can measure the power consumed during the short circuit test. After that, I need to find out what is 5SC, power factor during the short circuit test. That is nothing but power during the SC test divided by root 3 into VSC into ISC. Yes, these values are required to draw the circle diagram of a three-phase induction motor. Along with that, some other data is also required. That is short circuit current when rated voltage is applied. During a block rotor test, we are going to apply not more than 20% of the rated voltage. Theoretically, we need to determine what might be the block rotor current when we apply the rated voltage during the block rotor test. Along with that, we should know what is the value of stator resistance, and we should know what is the value of rotor resistance. The stator resistance and the rotor resistance can be obtained by conducting the DC test. With this data, we can go ahead for drawing the circuit diagram of a three-phase induction motor. Yes, we have taken two axes, a y-axis and x-axis. X-axis and y-axis, we are measuring the per phase voltage. Next, draw the IOC at an angle 5OC with respect to V. During this experiment, during the no-load test, the power factor angle, that is 5OC, will rise between 80 to 85 degrees. Okay, based on this, I am going to draw the IOC. This is the angle we are going to measure. And somewhere here, I'll assume that I am going to get IOC. After drawing the IOC, from the end of this line, draw a line parallel to x-axis. Let me call this point as O, and let me consider this point as O. The length OO dash represents the IOC. This represents the current IOC. And this angle, the angle between V phase and IOC, is nothing but a no load power factor angle. Let me write here 5OC. Next, measure this. The short circuit current when rated voltage is applied to the induction motor when the rotor is completely blocked. During this test, we are applying only the 10 to 20% of the rated voltage. For 10 to 20% of the rated voltage, you are going to get the rated current. Think, let's suppose if you apply the rated voltage during the block rotor test, the magnitude of the current will be very high. Yes, let me consider ISN. Let me call this current as ISN. ISN represents a short circuit current when rated voltage is applied, and this is drawn at an angle of 5SC. Now draw a line between O dash and A. Yes, I draw the line between O dash and A. The line O dash and A is called as output line. For a line O dash and A, draw the perpendicular bisector. We call this point as B. With B as a center and B O dash as a radius, draw the semicircle. With B as a center and O dash B as a radius, we have drawn the semicircle. That point obviously will pass through the point A. From point A, drop the perpendicular line until it touches X axis. Let me call this point as C and let me call this point as D. The next, now I need to draw the torque line. The torque line will depends upon the what is the resistance of the rotor circuit and what is the resistance of the stator circuit. Let's suppose if I assume that the resistance of the rotor and the stator circuits are same, then at exactly midpoint I can start drawing the torque line like this. From O dash, draw a line up exactly middle between the points A and C. If the rotor resistance are same, let me call this point as CF. Now, from point A, draw a line, extend the line up to A dash. This is based upon the maximum power rating, that is the rated output, and it is also based on the power scale. The power scale is calculated by using the length AD, that will be discussed a bit later. Let me name this as A dash. From the end of the A dash, draw a line parallel to output line until it touches the curve. Let me name this point as G. From point G, from G, drop the perpendicular line to X axis. Let me name this point as the H. Along with that, let me give a name for other points also. Let me name, these are the important points for our discussion. This is one point, this is one more point, and this is the one more point. Let me name these points. Yes, we are given the names for that. AF represents a rotor copper loss and FC represents stator copper loss and CD represents the constant loss. And this is drawn based upon the rated output. From O, draw a line up to G. This is the current drawn by the motor at rated load. And this will be the operating power factor. O dash F is called as the torque line. Now with this, the drawing the circle diagram is almost over. You need to determine the values like what is the maximum output, what is the maximum torque, what is the maximum input, what is the maximum power factor also you can determine with the help of the circle diagram. To find out maximum output, draw a line parallel to output line and tangential to circle. So this is not a tangent. This is also not a tangent. Maybe this is the tangent. Let me call this point as up to M I used. Let me call this point as N. From point N, drop the perpendicular line to X axis until it touches the output line. Let me call this point as P. The length NP represents the maximum output. Similarly, you can determine the maximum torque. To determine the maximum torque, same way, I am trying to draw a line parallel here to torque line. It should be tangent to the circle diagram. Yes, this is the tangent. From this point, drop the perpendicular line. From this point, drop the perpendicular line until it touches the torque line. Let me name this point as R. Let me name this point as S. You can determine the maximum input. To find out the maximum input that that can be fed to the induction motor, draw a line parallel to x-axis and it should be tangent curve. Obviously, let me try to see where I'll get the tangent. Maybe here I'll get. From this point, drop the perpendicular line, and this length represents the maximum input. All these things should be measured based on the power scale. Let me call this point as T, and let me call this point as U. Before starting further calculation, first we need to find out the power scale. The power scale can be calculated by considering this area. Let me copy this and show it separately. Yes, one represents the rotor copper loss, stator copper loss, and these are the losses when rated voltage is applied during the block rotor test. The power scale is calculated by using this formula. That is the total losses during block rotor test when rated voltage is applied is calculated by using these formulas. And the power scale is calculated as power scale is equal to PSN divided by the length AD, that is this represents the power scale. Yes, we'll see what are the parameters that we can determine. Actually, this is the main thing that you need to consider. Let me redraw that separately. Yes, I drawn only that part. I am showing only that part. In here, in this part, GH, the point GH, represents total or input to motor. It represents input to motor. And the point MH, you know that, and the point MH is called as the constant loss. Similarly, the point LM, this length, it should be, everything should be measured on the power scale. The LM represents the stator copper losses. Similarly, LK represents the rotor copper losses. What GK represents? GK represents the rotor output. If I do GK plus LK, what is GK? Rotor output, rotor copper loss is nothing but if I add these two, obviously I'll get the input to rotor. Then we know the standard formula, the slip into rotor input is equal to rotor copper losses. Or the slip S can be determined by rewriting this rotor copper loss divided by rotor input. What is the rotor copper loss? Is LK. And what is the rotor input? CR. So to determine the power factor, I need to consider this complete triangle. Let me show this part separately. Yes, this is that part. Yes, the operating power factor can be written as the operating power factor when the load is applied is equal to GH divided by OG. Like this, you can determine what is the rotor efficiency and you can determine what is the motor efficiency also. From this, I can tell what is the efficiency of motor. Let me write here, the efficiency of motor is equal to output of the motor divided by input of the motor. The output of the motor is nothing but output of the rotor. What is the output of the rotor? The output of the rotor is GK. What is the input of the motor is nothing but GH. Yes, by measuring this, you can determine the efficiency of motor. The efficiency of the rotor can be calculated alone. GK is the output of the rotor. GK divided by GL. GL is the input to the rotor. Like this, you can determine so many parameters related to the three-phase induction motor by conducting the no load test and the block rotor test.